So LeBron passed up Moses Malone yesterday. And First Take decided to debate if he's a top five player. Why are we debating if the greatest player of all time is in the top five? I don't fucking know. But everybody was tweeting me this, so I'm sure it's going to piss me off. Month, so let's
LeBron
just fucking
James
watch
moved
it,
into
man.
Ninth place on the list of all-time scorers, and last night he moved up the list again. In the Cavs' overtime win over the Bucks, LBJ passed Moses Malone for eighth all-time with 27,442 points. Next on the list for LeBron to catch, the Diesel, but it might take a while.
He'll pass him.
Has over 1,000 more career points
than
the King. So he posed this
He'll
question to you all on Twitter
Don't
earlier.
Worry.
Is LeBron James a top five player of all time? Results are in, and 72% say yes.
You know what?
Don't make.
I'm not sure. And a lot of people are gonna, you know, be up in arms about that because they're used to me being very, very definitive. I can't be definitive. This is the one question, Max. I can't be definitive with. Here's why: LeBron James to me is easily a top five player of all time. For the first 46 minutes. The last two, I'm not so sure. And that's where it comes in.
What did LeBron do last year in the finals? Did he not come back from down 3-1? What did he do the year before that? Did he not score 40 points every fucking game with no Kyrie and no Kevin Love? What the fuck are we talking about? Where is this he's not clutch shit coming from? What the did he not book? Oh my lord, this is just, oh
in
my god.
For me.
Oh my.
Now, if you go by position, sure he's top five. Because I'm going to put Kobe behind MJ at the two. I'm going to put Magic at the one. I'm going to put LeBron ahead of Larry Bird. I'm going to put Kareem Abdul-Jabbar in the middle, a six-time champion, the league's all-time leading scorer. I'm going to put Tim Duncan as my top power forward of all time. But if you take, if you just shove aside positions and whatever, I give LeBron nothing but respect and deference because of his greatness over the course of time, what he does on both ends of the floor, what he does for 46 minutes a night. But when crunch time arrives, when palms get sweaty and backsides get tight, I can't put him there. I gotta put Bird ahead of him. I gotta put Jordan ahead of him. I'm damn sure gonna put Kobe ahead of him. I'm gonna put these guys ahead of him. That's the difference for me.
And are we just gonna act like Kobe doesn't have the most misses of all time?
I will openly admit, Max, I am.
Are we just gonna act like Kobe's player efficiency rating isn't shit? And I've got on a Kobe jersey right now, but y'all pissing me off.
As it pertains to that, because I don't ignore the last 2 minutes. I don't ignore overtime. I don't ignore crunch time.
Nor should
those
you.
Those pivotal moments. I can't do it. But I can look over the totality of a game, the totality of a season, and to tell you for 82 games a year, plus playoffs, plus finals, LeBron is easily top five. But if I shove that aside and elevate the importance of crunch time, the last 2 minutes,
then he's
I'm
still
not
top
gonna
five.
Lie to you.
Then he's still top five, bitch.
Are you ready for this?
Then he's still top five.
Put Dwayne Wade ahead of him in the last 2 minutes.
Okay, he's still top five that way. By the way, LeBron James choked away four consecutive fourth quarters in the finals against the Mavericks in 10-11, right? He did that. That ship has sailed. It's never coming back. It's one of the reasons he'll never be greater than Michael Jordan. However, to paint him with that brush as though he chokes under pressure ignores a lot of other fourth quarters, late and close, finals and playoff games.
Bro,
and
MJ didn't go every single fucking year. What the fuck is...
Stephen A., he's been more clutch than Kobe Bryant in those situations. But let's leave that alone for a second. The comparison, people will throw up their
eyeballs. I disagree with that, but go ahead. I disagree with that.
Stephen A., you shut your little big forehead ass the fuck up.
The record of events says differently. Let's look at these last playoffs.
Well, those are stats you picking out. There are others, but go ahead.
Let's look at these last playoffs.
Bitch, player efficiency rating, pussy.
The finals, when he was down 3-1 to a 73-win team, the all-time winningest team.
Let's...
down 3-1.
Wasn't this not just today, fucking
not
last year?
Had home court advantage. And on Sports Nation at the time, I remember turning to the camera and saying, okay, LeBron, Muhammad Ali had to go into Zaire and fight.
So I don't understand why we keep talking about this magic shit. Okay, I mean this Maverick shit. Okay, he wasn't clutch against the Mavericks. Okay, but then we just want to act like coming back from a 3-1 has ever been done in fucking history doesn't offset that shit. We just gotta act like that doesn't fucking offset it, bitch. That offsets it. What the fuck? I don't give a fuck if he would have got swept by the Mavericks. If you come and you beat the Warriors, who have the best record of all time, the best shooters of all time, and you come back and win a 3-1 against them, motherfucker, we should never be bringing up the Mavericks again. The Mavericks should never get brought up. That shit didn't happen from here on out. What the fuck? I'm tired of, like, bro, y'all can't just pick and choose when y'all want to hate on him and when y'all, like, bro, that shit doesn't matter.
No way he can win that fight. Here's your Rumble in the Jungle. Here is where the legends are made. Here is where legacy is truly made. When you do the impossible, and they did it. And it was because of LeBron James. The season before, he had one of the all-time great finals in a losing effort because Kyrie and Kevin Love were both hurt. They were gone. He tried to do it all himself, took it a competitive 6 games. And then this time, with his crew, down 3-1 to the greatest regular season team that ever was, that did just come back on a Thunder team that was, you know, all-time great, maybe, had it not been for the Warriors coming back in them and beating them. LeBron James led them down 3-1.
Stephen A. Bro, you got it, like.
When Draymond Green, who otherwise
there's no consistency,
MVP,
bro. You can't just LeBron give him praise foul, in the finals, and then when we have this discussion, you want to bring up the Mavericks and shit, like.
Finals on the line, misses the free throw because of the hand, and you saw him on the free throw line making the mental adjustments. Okay, I got to tweak this, and hitting the shot that iced the finals in one of the all-time great finals appearances. You want to still say he's not clutch? He's absolutely top
he's
five.
The
best player of all time is Michael Jordan. That might not ever change.
It will change, bitch. It'll change, Max. It'll change, Max.
Two spot, 2-3. That's fine. Then it's LeBron James.
Thank you. And that's all we need. And we don't need to hear anything else. We're done. I don't need to hear anything else. I don't want to hear. Okay, fine. We'll keep listening. I don't want to hear anything else.
That he's actually won, including the one I just mentioned, one where he got them there, a Cleveland team that had no business in the finals. He led them there. If you look at the peak of his career, it's as good as anyone but Michael Jordan's, maybe Kareem's, but it's
talk that
it's
fucking
right
shit, Max. Will you talk that shit, Max? Thank you, Max.
Value,
thank you, Max. Thank you. Thank you, Max.
Floor,
thank you, Max. Thank you, Max.
He's a yes. Defender,
yes.
Bigger, stronger,
yes.
Faster,
yes.
Are more
yes.
Now.
Yes.
And you
talk
look at
it.
The
talk it.
Prime, the fact
talk
that he's
it.
Still going, the fact
talk
that he
it.
Probably should be like an 8-time MVP.
Talk
there
it.
Is no way to
talk
keep LeBron
it.
James
talk
out of
it.
The top five
talk
of all.
It.
Stephen A., real
talk
quick,
it.
Before you jump on him,
talk
can you just
it.
Clarify one
talk
thing
for
me? I need a lot clarified because he said so much. I mean, I thought I was taking a class at MIT with all of these damn analytics people. That is not the same as watching the game. And watching the game is entirely different.
I took you through the Draymond play.
I still am shocked that Max Kellerman uses his numbers more than his eyes. With those Beetlejuice eyes, I do not understand why this man does not exercise the eye test more.
I don't get it. How can you see the size of my eyes from your deluxe apartment in the sky?
It is a nice apartment.
Stephen A. I just need you to say one thing. You have D. Wade above LeBron. Why?
No, I did not say that.
Okay,
Once again, I did not say that.
I don't even want to listen to this anymore.
The first time. I said
no,
the last 2 minutes. I said crunch time, last 2 minutes. If I had to give the ball to one person or the other, I'm going to give it to D. Wade in crunch time. And I make no apologies for that. A 3-time champion, one of the most clutch players in history, D. Wade. In the last 2 minutes? Are you kidding
LeBron
me?
Are you kidding me, motherfucker? Are you kidding me?
No.
What the fuck? Are you kidding me?
I got to get in here because you threw out all those numbers. You threw out all those numbers. Let me tell you something right now. First of all, let's remember the fact that the Western Conference, for the vast majority of LeBron James' career, okay, has been the tougher conference with far more stiffer competition. He's been very, very comfortable in the Eastern Conference. Let's not ignore that. The level of competition that you go up against. Hell, I'd look good, too, if half my games were against Detroit and Atlanta and Orlando back in the day and all of these other people. And the only stiff competition I have was the occasional contest against the Pacers or the Knicks or the Boston Celtics or somebody. I mean, give me a break. So let's not ignore
you keep
that.
Running into the Showtime Lakers. It's not easy for you. I get it.
Wait a minute. It's not just the Showtime Lakers. It was the Spurs. It was other teams within the Western Conference as well. We also got a guy in Kobe Bryant that's been all defensive team more so than LeBron that has 5 rings, not 3. And then also,
are you going to argue that Kobe is a better defensive player than LeBron? I will turn this off and never watch you ever again in my life.
Ultimately do it without Shaq, even though that was of his doing. We've got that to take into consideration. All I'm saying is you're absolutely right. Nothing to discuss if you're talking about the first 46 minutes.
But here's the problem.
Tell me that one performance in the finals ultimately makes LeBron
clutch. He has a lot of clutch performances.
To the point where we
LeBron has had a lot of clutch performances.
Yes, he does.
Yes.
He's also had a lot of failures.
Well, okay.
He's also had a lot of failures.
Okay. I want to get to that.
More failures or successes?
Come on.
This is the problem with LeBron.
Nigga, you've had failures. What the fuck, Kevin Durant got on your ass?
It
extended beyond early.
Fine.
You're Kevin Durant's bitch.
For the finals that he had against Dallas. However, to ignore the fact that he's
Skip Bayless made you. I'm on your ass.
Into a great clutch.
Fat boy ass.
Well, okay, but that's what he is now. So, if you want to take the peak of his career, where he's better than
a lot of
the guys
you just
mentioned.
Yes, including
Kobe in his prime, the peak of LeBron.
It's pissing me off.
And if you want to take that peak, well, guess what? He is a clutch player now. And if you want to say, I want to average in the career, his career value is amazing too.
But I'm trying to get to your point. Because this is a point that I don't want to let you ignore. Listen to me. I'm not playing. Listen, because I'm trying to get to your point. Here's the deal. You want to take into account what he did in what he's doing now.
Yes.
And basically, by and large, ignore those prime years. I, on the other hand, am taking into account what guys did in their primes and somewhat ignoring attrition and father time diminishing what they did. Which is more valuable in terms of judgment? Am I judging you by what you do when it counts, when you're young, when you're vibrant, when you're in your prime, or when you're old and father time got the best of you? Which way are you doing it?
I got a better way of doing it. You're drafting a team and you're drafting players, and the point is this: win as many championships as you can with this player. LeBron is being drafted in the top 5. You are drafting Michael Jordan.
And then LeBron! Russell, no! You're going Michael and then LeBron!
I'm not offended by that. I do understand, because what you're doing is taking
into
account.
Who the fuck is picking Bill Russell before LeBron? I'm picking LeBron first!
I get that.
Fuck MJ, I'm picking LeBron first!
Because again, that's what lends me towards saying he's easily top 5 because of those first 46 minutes and what he does for everybody. Specifically said, where he diminishes in my eyes are those last 2 minutes when it ain't about those
this
other
is
guys.
So painful.
It's about you.
This
it's
is
about
so painful.
You.
He's
it's
become
about you.
This is so
that.
Painful. I'm about to like punch my fucking screen.
I saw Kyrie close. I appreciate the block from LeBron James. I saw LeBron showed up. LeBron was a superstar. He was the MVP. We get all of that. But I specifically said, he got the MVP because of his overall performance. The last 2 minutes.
Okay, let me ask you this.
Who am I giving ball to? I'm giving it to Kobe. I'm giving it to MJ. I'm giving it to Bird. Am I giving it to LeBron?
Here's the problem.
Am I giving it
to him? If you reduce this argument to a last couple of plays hero ball argument, then you will prefer the type of player who wants to play that kind of game.
That's not true.
Like Kobe
That's not
Bryant.
True.
That doesn't
That's not
mean.
True.
Wait, let me finish.
That is
that
true.
Doesn't mean
that makes perfect
elevates
sense.
Your chance to win in that situation over LeBron. It means he elevates the odds that he will be the one who scores the winning basket.
Right.
Doesn't necessarily mean his team is more likely
right.
to win than LeBron's.
Right. Man, will you, talk that fucking shit, Max?
Allow me to be arrogant enough to say, let me break down this basketball fact to you. In the end, all those things you say are obvious components to the game of basketball and judging the overall value of a player. But what separates the truly, truly special ones, all of these dudes are going into the Hall of Fame. But what
I don't think I've ever been this mad before.
In that different room from the regular dudes is not just titles. It's dudes that were given the ball when it counted, and they said, look, everybody. everything else has fallen apart, I need you to take me to the promised land in these last couple of minutes.
Who you taking?
Can
LeBron
you do
Bird?
It?
Who you taking?
In
LeBron?
The last 2 minutes?
No, who you
in
taking? Period. Who you taking? Period.
No, I told you that. I don't do that. I don't do that.
That's the fucking.
I got LeBron. You
taking,
got Bird?
I'm taking LeBron. Because
Bird's bad.
For the first 46 minutes. I want Bird for the last two.
You can't. You have to.
Can.
You can't do it like that.
Right, motherfucker. You fat forehead bitch.
I'm the one with the basketball credentials on the show, not y'all.
Therefore, you get to make a team.
I can
sub out LeBron.
Yes, I can do that.
Guys, don't answer the question.
All right, I'm done. It was only 5 seconds left anyways. Okay, I'm done. All right, tweet me more, D. Instagram, YouTube, comment. Subscribe if you're new. Stephen A., this is like an all-time low for you, bro. Like, you, like, what are you even talking about? He just asked you, who are you picking? And you're going to say, I'm picking LeBron and then Bird in the last 2 minutes? No, you can't do that, motherfucker. That's not answering the question. I'm not even going to sit here and ramble because I'll be sitting here all fucking. This is some fucking bullshit. What the fuck is he? I'm so tired of y'all bringing up. The man came back during what? That's never been fucking done before. When is the next time you'll never, none of you will ever see that shit again in your fucking lives, as long as you fucking live. What the fuck is he? He act like that shit just gets. I'm out of here. Max for president, dude. This is Max's show. Skip made you, pussy. You fat forehead, pussy. Long forehead.